Hello friends, I've had a really magical few days. It's one of those experiences I'm writing in my diary on the way over here that makes me realize why magical realism as a genre is something that I find so accurate to the experience of human life, because there are so many moments of magic and coincidence and of these things, these kind of confluences of things coming together that just absolutely blow my mind. But I want to start on Friday, because on Friday I went to All Points East. And that's a festival here, well, not here in London, because I'm in Belfast right now. That's a festival in London, in London's Victoria Park. I saw my friend Lucy in the afternoon. I had been thinking initially of maybe not going because I'd felt really rubbish all day. I just felt really not myself. But, and the same way I did feel like myself, because I struggled to sort of be seen and be visible and all of that. But I thought, hey, you love the yeah, yeah, yes. You haven't seen them in a long, long time, so you should just go, and you can always leave if you want to. And yeah, Lucy said, let's go get a drink. So we went to a pub and had, you know, a Coke and some fries and things like that before the festival. That was really lovely. That cheered me up a lot and made me feel really excited for the show. And I went to the Yeah Yeah Yeahs. I hadn't planned to be anywhere near the front. I just thought, oh, I'll weave my way through and get kind of where I can get. But because there had been an act on before and then people wanted to go and see stuff on the other stage, I ended up basically at the front, like second row, which was amazing because yes, are so core to my experience and my love for the genre of music I love, for the period of music in which all of my favorite bands, almost all of my favorite bands, were formed. And that's like the 2000s, like everyone pretty much in Meet Me in the Bathroom by Lizzie Goodman, like it has a core memory associated for me and my love of music. But the Yeah Yeah Yeahs specifically, and Karen O being this woman heading a rock band, being so visible, so huge in performance and in joy and in rage and in all of these things. And these moments during the set where, during Y Control, for instance, where they have these old pictures of the Yeah Yeah Yeahs and pictures and headlines and bits that I think I recognize from having torn out and put on my very own school books and things like that, and covered in sticky back plastic. And just, it was such a time, and it was such a celebration of that time, but also where we are now and of things changing and all of that. So that was an absolute delight. And I met all these lovely people around me and was just having a fantastic evening. After that, I went to see The Strokes, but I only saw a few songs because I knew I had an early start the following day. And I was also very kind to myself because I knew I was tired. I knew that my reserves were pretty low and I thought, well, I'll just do what I can and then go when I need to go. So I ate pizza, listened to The Strokes. They played last night really early, so I was very happy to get some of that Is This It action, and headed off and went back home. And the next morning, woke up early. I'd found out that there were train strikes, which I had no idea about because I've just been completely out of it and like occupied with other things, just not really, just kind of dissociative and like not really with it. So I found out there were train strikes. I was like, oh God, but the trains were still running to Reading. Some trains were still running to Reading day of. So I went in the morning, but I didn't really know how I was going to get back. There was like some vague plan about a cab or something, but I knew it was going to be a pain. I should just go and then work it out later. But it transpired later that one of my friends was getting a lift back with them and so didn't need her return coach ticket. So that worked out great. But like all of this strange little magic has happened, all this strange super blue moon magic where I was walking down like Reading, I don't even know if it was Reading High Street, but a street from Reading Station towards the festival. And this hand sticks out of a car window and waves at me. And it's my friends, my killer's friends, who were just parking literally right past where I was walking. And I had been thinking like, how are we going to find each other? There's probably no signal in the festival, but it just so happened that not even when we hadn't even got there yet, and we ran into each other. So that was really, really lovely. And it meant we went in together. Initially, we asked where the stage, like the East stage, I think it was, where the Killers were playing was, and someone sent us in the wrong direction. And then we ran back and we were all so stressed out and went back to the other stage. Once we saw that everyone at the stage we'd gone to initially had 1975 shirts on, we were like, oh no, this is the wrong stage. So we went back the other way. And actually it meant that we saw that everyone who'd arrived there already was on the left hand side of these little pen things. And we wanted to go on the right hand side. And there's like a gap in the middle and you can't sort of hop over. So it worked out really well. We literally just strolled up to the barrier next to two baby queen vans and their dad, and it was just brilliant. It was one of the easiest barrier experiences ever. I'd imagine that it was going to take a little while to get barrier, like you wait for someone to see the artist they're waiting for, but no, it worked out perfectly. The day went really well. I loved seeing Nothing But Thieves play. I really enjoyed Inhaler, and also just enjoyed the intensity and the ferocity with which the Inhaler fans were celebrating them, because it just reminded me a lot of that period of time, of the 2000s, when all this music was happening, when I was going to like Camden for the first time and seeing little bands and names I recognized from NME, and thinking about, oh, when I'm older, I want to write for NME, and just all of that kind of stuff. It just really filled me with a lot of love. And Reading's a really young festival. It's like the festival you go to after you get your GCSEs. It's often your first festival. For me, it was a lot of firsts of seeing people sort of experiment and sort of push the boundaries a little bit of their own experience among my friends. And I hadn't been for, I think I worked out it was like 16 years maybe. And I kind of been dreading, to be honest, the sort of youngness of the festival. But it was a really, really fun day. At the same time, a Killers article came out that was very dramatic about like the end of the Killers, from an interview with Brandon. And it was good to be with my Killers friends as that happened. But also it was really nice to have that experience of like concern and worry, and then see the Killers come out and put on the most tremendous show and debut their new song for the first time live. It had come out a couple of days before. It's called Your Side of Town. I love it. So fun to dance to. In the context of everything, like all that concern from the day, and just seeing like, oh, this was a really happy, joyful, exciting, brilliant festival performance. It was just a wonderful counter to it. So then the Sunday, my friends in Fizz were playing at Punch Drunk. We're playing in the Burnt City. So my friends have formed this band Fizz. It's really beautiful. I love all their music. I love the harmonies. I love the way they sing together anyway. So when they started kind of playing about with forming a band, I'm so excited. And Dodie's a massive Punch Drunk fan. So they set up basically doing a set at the Burnt City, which was an amazing tying together of all these different things I love. I had a great, we did the like Burnt City show as normal. And then after that, they performed. I had a great Burnt City show. I loved the kind of characters and storylines I went to some sort of old favourites. And then afterwards, we were led through back through like Troy. And I thought the performance was going to be in Troy Square, but actually it was in one of the bedrooms in the Elysium Hotel, which has this like big headboard that looks like a shell and all this neon outline in it. And it was just the perfect space for it. We were all sitting on the floor. No one could have their phones. And it was just calm and wonderful. And they played one of my favorite songs, which is Close One. I think Close One is my favorite Fizz song. I just adore it. I adore it so much. And then after that, went back to the Bar and Peep, which where Fizz performed another set. And yeah, I just saw a lot of people who hadn't seen forever and catched up. I saw people I hadn't seen forever. And I caught up with friends who were kind of like longtime friends, because like I've known some of those girls for like, I don't know, like 10 years, 12 years. And then I also ran into a lot of new friends I've made through the Burnt City, like through that community. So it was just a really lovely balance. And I kept kind of having these moments of reflection and gratitude for these communities, these environments, and for music in general. And I also made myself go up to the creative director and the co-founder of and the founder of Punch Drunk and introduce myself and thank them for it and tell them about this contemporary dance class I'm starting in a few weeks, because I'm trying to say thank you while I can and express thank yous. And sometimes it's very difficult because I just don't have the words for those experiences, but I'm just trying to do it anyway, and partly because it pushes me past my fear. So that was wonderful. And afterwards also got to meet another creative director, another performer in the cast, had a great time. And it was another of those things where I just left feeling really like buzzy and lovely. Monday, so it was bank holiday here in the UK. So Monday was a holiday and I've taken this whole week off work. Monday, I went to see Haim at All Points East. Haim are like my other favourite band. Like I love The Killers more than life. And then I love Haim. I love the Haim a lot. It's not about favourites. I just adore them. And I hadn't seen them in a long time. And I was so excited to see them at All Points East. And they put on such a show. And it's the 10-year anniversary of their first album, Days Are Gone. They're doing an anniversary show in the UK, in London tomorrow, which I'm not going to be there for. But I did, yeah, I mean, like I have tickets, like I saw them at Coco like 10 years ago and at Latitude at like 3 p.m. in the afternoon, things like that. Like it's been so fun to watch them grow and then see them do this massive, massive show at All Points East, this headline show. It was just wicked. So that was really fun. And then from there, I rushed to Euston and got on the sleeper train. I went to Edinburgh because the Killers were playing in Edinburgh on Tuesday. And Tuesday, oh man, like huge all day. Entry to that show was an absolute mess. But the show itself was absolutely fantastic. They put on such a fun set list, flipped everything upside down, opened with Mr. Brightside, played Bling, played, what else did they, oh, The Hole of the Moon. And it was, the Super Blue Moon was really coming into full force at that point. And it was just such a fun, fun, fun show. Johnny Marr opened. They played This Charming Man at the end with Johnny Marr. And I was there with so many of my friends and people who I've met only in the last few years, like at most probably like 4 or 5 years, but most of them only about a year, who I adore so much, all in one kind of, in one place, celebrating this love of a band and celebrating Killers. And it was a spectacular show, like one of the absolute best Killer shows I've ever seen. And from there, then went back to my hotel, ate a jacket potato, was very happy because it was freezing cold. And after that, so now we're on Wednesday, which is today. Today, woke up late, managed to get a late checkout, which was very exciting because my flight wasn't until the afternoon. Got to the airport, stopped getting ready, like, walking around, deciding what I'm going to do, deciding what I'm going to eat, and I go to the bathroom, walk out, walking past down, you know, the main airport bit. Who do I see coming towards me? Brandon Flowers, lead singer of the Killers, Brandon Flowers. And he smiles and he goes, and I just turn to him and go, thank you so much for the show last night. And he sticks out his hand and gives a very firm handshake and we part ways. And it is one of those things that I will never forget, hopefully. I hope to never forget it because it was just, it's just indicative of the Super Blue Moon magic. And on my way to the airport, I saw baby bunnies. So I really don't know what else to say than that. But I'm here in Belfast. I'm seeing the Killers on Friday again. And I'm just filled with gratitude and love. And also for myself, for chasing the things that I want to do, for doing them, and for being a little more gentle on myself, less judgmental about the choices like that. And just for loving it, for really loving it. And for, you know, it's had all of this, you know, there have been huge ups and downs in this week and as much as any other week, especially summer, which has been so hard. But as we come to the end of August, my favorite month of the year, I'm just so, so grateful for all of the joy that's found me and all the people I've got to share it with. So yeah, that's where I am right now.